Hello children, let's continue chapter 16, right? Before we continue our chapter, let's have a quick recap of light, whatever we have learned in the last session. In the last session, we have learned about what is light. Light is a form of energy that enables us to see around us. Or we can say that light is an electromagnetic wave that can travel through medium as well as without medium, that is through vacuum. Then how do we see objects? Our eyes alone do not allow us to see. That is, light from source falls on an object and then bounces off onto our eyes, and that is how we see the objects, or that is how we perceive objects. Then we have learned about two types of objects, luminous objects and non-luminous objects. Non-luminous objects, otherwise we can call that as illuminated objects. What are luminous objects? Luminous objects are those objects which has its own light, which emits its own light. And non-luminous objects are those which do not has its own light. And this luminous objects, objects which can produce light on their own. Example, tube light, bulb, sun, stars, candle, then when wood is burnt, that flame. So these are all examples of luminous objects. And non-luminous objects, that is illuminated objects, objects that do not produce light on their own, but they reflect the light that falls upon them, are called as illuminated object. Example, moon. Then when light falls on any surface, any one of the phenomenon takes place, like light falling on the surface, either they may get absorbed, what we call that as absorption, or light falling on the surface may pass through the surface, like through glass. When light falls on glass, if it falls on clear glass, all the light can easily pass through it. This is transmission. And light for when the light falls through tinted glass, some of the light will pass through it. So this, on the basis of this, we can call that as when light falling on the surface, they may pass through the surface. Or sometimes light falling on the surface of some objects, they bounce back. They, what is that bouncing back? That is bouncing back of light rays on striking the surface, what we call that as reflection. So what is reflection? Reflection is nothing but the bouncing back of light rays on the striking the surface. So this, which are the objects that reflect the light? The object should have a shiny surface, object should have polished surface, or object should have smooth surface. So these are the characteristics of best reflector. That is best, the object which can reflect should have shiny surface or polished surface, or it should have smooth surface. For example, if you see, silver metal is a best reflector. That is, we can, this plain glass, when it is coated with silver on one side, silver coating, it makes the glass into a plain mirror. So silver, because silver metal is the best reflector. And what happens when light falls on a mirror? So when a light falls on a mirror, it gets reflected back. That is, we know that light is a form of energy, and because of which we can see objects, and lights can be called as radiation. Radiation of light, that is emitted, reflected, or absorbed by different objects. So just now we have seen what any one of the this may happen when light falls on object. Either it may be emitted, or get reflected, or get absorbed. And a mirror, if you take, it is a glass having a shiny surface. Just now I told, a mirror, a glass, when it is coated with silver, thin coating of silver, it gets converted into mirror. And the when a light falls on a mirror, what happens? It gets reflected back, because the best reflector should have a shiny surface. So it light falls on a mirror, it gets reflected back, and hence a mirror changes the direction of light that falls upon it. And thus now we will continue. So this reflection of light, what are the laws of reflection of light? So now we are going to learn about laws of reflection. So before that, we'll learn what is reflection of light. That is, when the light strikes the surface, it gets bounced back. This bouncing back of light rays, what we call that as reflection. Here in the figure, you can see that incoming light, that is the light falls on a surface of the mirror. And this light, when it falls, a ray, we call that as beam of light. The light rays together, what we call that as beam of light. Beam, we use the word beam. Beam of light, when the light rays falls on the surface of a mirror, this beam of light, what we call that as incident ray, incoming light, what we call that as incident ray. And the point where it strikes the surface, we call that as point of incidence. And after it strikes the mirror, it gets reflected back. So this ray, what we call that as reflected rays or reflected light. And so what are the terms we have learned till now? Incident ray, that is the ray that strikes the surface. And what is point of incidence? The point at which the incident ray strikes the surface is called as point of incidence. And what is reflected ray? The light rays that bounces back on the striking surface is called as reflected ray. And if you draw a perpendicular line between this incident ray and reflected ray, we call that as normal ray. So children, incident ray, the ray of light that falls on the surface is called incident ray. Reflected ray, the ray of light that gets reflected back from the surface after getting incident, after it strikes the surface, is called as reflected ray. And what is normal? Normal is an just imaginary line, perpendicular line that is drawn to the reflecting surface at the point of incidence, or you can tell at the point where the incident ray strikes the surface, is called as normal. And you have, now we will be having angle, one angle, the angle of incidence, that is the angle between the incident ray and the normal forms angle of incidence. The same way, the angle between the reflected ray and the normal, it forms angle of reflection. So if you tell, for incident, an incident ray, there is always one reflected ray. So now, after striking the mirror, the ray of light is reflected in another direction, and the light ray which strikes the surface is called as incident ray, and the ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as reflected ray. And so suppose if you draw a line showing the position of the plane mirror. So now we have to find out this, what are the laws of reflection. So for that, we have to draw a line showing the position of plane mirror, and draw incident ray and the reflected ray on the paper. And now remove the mirror. In last session, we have learned about one activity, isn't it? By keeping a comb and by passing the light through the comb, in only middle portion of the comb is kept open. And when the light falls through the comb, when it strikes the mirror, and it gets reflected back, isn't it? So now the same experiment, now we'll be removing the mirror, and in place of mirror, we'll draw a line. And we just draw a line of incident ray and reflected ray. Now draw a line making angle of 90 degree, that is perpendicular line, where the incident ray strikes the surface, that is a point of incidence. The incident, what is point of incidence? The point at which the incident ray strikes the surface of the mirror is called as point of incidence. At this point we have to draw a perpendicular line. So this line, what we call that as normal, isn't it, to the reflecting surface. So now we have two angles, that is the angle between the normal and the incident ray is called as angle of incidence, and the angle between the normal and reflected ray, what we call that as angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is represented by small I and angle of reflection is represented by small r. Now if we measure the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection, what we see is, and both will be equal. So we have to repeat this activity several times by changing the angle of incidence. In all, whenever you change the angle of incidence, you get angle of reflection also the same. So here, if you see the relation between the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection, they are equal. So if you see, if you carry out the experiment carefully, it is seen that angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. So this is known as first law of reflection. So what is first law, what we have learned is angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. So, children, so now we have learned about first law of reflection. The angle of incidence and the angle of reflection are always equal, or we can tell the angle by which the ray of light is incident on a surface will always be equal to the angle by which it is reflected back from the surface. Any one definition you can learn, very simple one, this angle of first law of reflection is angle of incidence and angle of reflection are always equal to each other. Now let us learn about the other law. For this, let's have one activity. Now we have to use a sheet or stiff paper or a chart paper. Instead of this comb, we'll use now sheet of chart paper. Now let the sheet project a little beyond the edge of the table. See, you can see in the figure, near the edge of the table we have to project the sheet. Now what we have to do is we have to cut the projecting portion of the sheet in the middle. That is, we have to keep the light which is passed through the middle portion of the sheet of the paper. Now what you can see is the same way, you have to keep the plane mirror on the other side. When the light is passed through the paper, we can see that the light get reflected back. Now look at that reflected ray. Now make sure that the reflected ray extend to the projected portion of the paper on which the light reflected ray falls. Now what we have to do is you have to bend the paper, part of the projected paper, you have to bend the paper. Now again you have to pass through the light, pass through it the bend projected portion of the paper. Now when the paper is bent, can we see the reflected ray? No. Now again bring the paper back to the original position. Now again you can see the reflected ray again. So when the whole sheet of the paper is spread on the table, it represents a one plane surface, plane. So the incident ray, the normal, and the point of incidence, the normal at the point of incidence and the reflected ray are all in the same plane. What, children? So what is that? The incident ray, point, the normal, where what is normal? The perpendicular line which is drawn through the point of incidence is called as normal. So the incident ray, the normal, and the reflected ray are all in the same plane. When we bend the paper, what we do, we create a plane different from the plane in which the incident ray and the normal lie. isn't it? That is why we do not see the reflected ray. So from this activity, we can understand that incident ray, the normal, and the reflected ray are all lying in the same plane. This is second law of reflection. So when the paper is bent, what happened? The incident ray and the normal will be in one plane, and the reflected ray will be in the other plane. So we cannot see the reflected ray. When the projected paper is straight, means all three, that is the incident ray, normal, and the reflected ray, all lie in the same plane. So this is called as second law of reflection. That is, the incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal are on the same plane. So children, till now we have learnt about two laws of reflection. That is, first law of reflection is angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. And second law states that incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal. Well, what is normal? Normal drawn at the point of incidence to the reflecting surface. All three lie in the same plane. Okay, children, we'll end this session now. We'll continue about the light in a detailed manner in the next session. Thank you.